Hey, I'm Alex with Splunk Education. In this video, we'll learn how to create and manage reports in Splunk.
You're probably already familiar with how to run ad hoc searches in Splunk. But what if you find yourself running the same searches over and over? This is where reports come in. There are multiple benefits to saving a search as a report. Reports can be scheduled, so you can get those sales numbers at 9 a.m. every Monday morning. You can use those same scheduled reports to update visualizations in the dashboard, preventing users from running multiple concurrent ad hoc searches. Scheduled alerts can trigger actions when criteria are met, such as sending an email notification or using a webhook to notify a chat room. We'll start by searching for unsuccessful login attempts on our servers over the last 7 days. From the search results page, we click Save As and select Report. We give our report a meaningful title and can optionally add a description. We also have the option to add a time range picker, so anyone viewing our report can run it again over a different span of time. We'll leave this set to yes and click save. From this confirmation dialog, we have the option to edit permissions, schedule, acceleration, and embedding settings. We can always return to these options later, so for now, we will view the report. Our saved report shows the title and events returned. Since we chose to show the time range picker, we can change the range of events shown. The Edit menu allows us to open our results in Search, edit the report's description, permissions, schedule, or acceleration settings, and clone, embed, or delete the report. To make this report accessible to other users in our environment, we click Edit Permissions. Different options are available depending on your user role. We're using an admin role for this demonstration, so we can choose to display the report for just the owner of the report, users in the current application, in our case, search and reporting, or across all apps installed on the instance. When we select App or All Apps, we can choose Read and Write permissions by user role. Please note the Run As option. This allows the report to either be run as the owner of the report or as the user that is running the report. If the report is run as user, only the data that the user has access to will be returned. If the report is run as owner, the data available to the owner will be seen by all users, including users that don't otherwise have access to it. We choose to give read access to every user of the current app and click Save. We can also schedule reports to run at regular intervals by clicking Edit Schedule. We see a message letting us know that scheduling this report will conflict with the permissions we previously defined, and that the time range picker will be removed. Scheduled reports are designed to search your data without needing to rely on user input and permissions. To avoid overriding our previous settings, let's clone this report. We give this report a new descriptive title and optional description, confirm the app context, leave this report set to private, and click Clone Report. We can now choose how often the report runs and the time range of the events to return. We can run our report every hour, day, week, or month, or set a custom option using a cron schedule. Setting a report to run every week allows us to choose a day of the week and a time, displayed in a 24-hour format. We want these results to be the first thing we see Monday morning, so we select 9 o'clock. Our existing time range picker will be removed and overridden by the selected time range. We will leave this set to last 7 days, the time range we selected when we ran our initial search. The schedule window lets you set an acceptable delay for the running report. If your report cannot run at exactly its scheduled time, it will run at the first available opportunity within its specified window. We select 5 minutes. We can also enable the report to trigger actions. These include logging an event to a Splunk receiver endpoint, outputting results to a lookup, sending results to a telemetry endpoint, running a script, sending an email, sending a notification via Splunk Mobile, or using a webhook to post to a URL. Splunk also lets users with an admin role install or build custom alert actions. To find pre-built alert actions, click the Manage Actions link. We've created and scheduled our report, but it hasn't run yet, so we're told the results are still pending. With a little movie magic, there we go. Monday morning at 9 a.m., and our report has run at its intended scheduled time. Way to go, report. The More Info dropdown allows us to see a summary of our report's settings and options to edit them. We can add this report to a new or existing dashboard by clicking the Add to Dashboard button. We can also create a report from the field sidebar. Let's run a search for successful purchases in our online store. By selecting a field name, we can then choose from a few report shortcuts. We can select from top or most frequently appearing values, top values by time, rare values, or events containing the selected field. Selecting top values appends a top command to our search. Because this type of report contains statistical information, it can be displayed as a visualization. We further edit this search to display only the top 5 products instead of the default value of 20. Save and view our new report. The Reports tab allows us to see all reports available to our role. We can choose to show all the reports or filter them by user or application. Expanding the dropdown to the left of the report name gives us a summary of the report's settings. We can open our reports in Search or use the Edit menu for quick links to edit our report's options.
This is just the beginning of what you can do with reports. We suggest you check out the documentation, watch additional videos on the Splunk How-To channel, and register for courses from Splunk Education. Happy Splunking!